Hello, my name is Nathan Lawson. I'm a person in long-term recovery, and what that means for me is that the past 7 years of my life, I have not had to use drugs or alcohol to cope with everyday life. And for a person like me, that is truly a miracle. I came from being a person that couldn't go 1 second without thinking about drugs or alcohol, how to get money to get more drugs and alcohol, how to manipulate the people around me, and just have no responsibility. So a little bit about myself. I was born in Farmington, New Mexico. I was raised by my mother and my grandmother. My biological father died when I was 9 months old in a car accident that was drug related. As a matter of fact, when they got into that accident, all of them were intoxicated, and he was hanging out of the sunroof of the car, and the car flipped, and he passed away. So the only father I've ever known is the person that I call my dad, right? And who is basically the person that's raised me since I was 18 months old. Eighth grade was the first time I picked up drugs. As a matter of fact, the first thing I picked up was alcohol, right? And I was in eighth grade, and my mom and dad had a bottle of Everclear under the sink, and I got the gallon and poured it into a Coleman thing and poured Dr. Pepper or Pepsi into it and took it to school. And in homeroom, the security officers coming in because I'm drunk and I'm getting other kids in the class drunk, And this all started for me in eighth grade. And then from there, it just really progressed, right? This disease of addiction is a progressive disease. It usually starts out as a manageable disorder, but slowly or sometimes very fastly for folks, it progresses into a point where it's not manageable no more, and that happened to me. So I went on into ninth grade, and I joined a gang, down south in Lawson. In those times, it was funny, I was having a conversation with my mom the other day, and back in those days, we didn't have anything, We didn't have a movie theater. We didn't have a bowling alley. I mean, literally the only thing to do in our town was to do drugs and alcohol and gangbang, and that's not an excuse, right? Because through the work that I've done in my recovery, I take accountability for my actions, and I take accountability for, the things that I did to people and the things that I did to myself. And that's really a wonderful thing, right? That progress that we go through in recovery. And, before going into the military, I never really messed with pills or Xanax or, stuff like that. And that's all it took, right? As I said, it's a progressive disease, right? So, at first I was able to take a little piece of Xanax and be cool and just sleep. Then slowly it turned into, I need a half a Xanax to sleep, right? Then soon enough it became, I need a whole Xanax every morning and night. Then eventually it came to the point where I was using a whole Xanax in the morning, at lunch, and at night. And then it just kept progressing, right? And to the point where I could not maintain my life. How could I go from, being an E4 corporal, E5 promotable, infantryman in the military with honor and respect and all these things, to somebody that was getting an under honorable conditions discharge, right? And it happened like that. And through the work that I've done in my own recovery, I know to date that no matter what, if I pick up any substance, that within 90 days, my life will be unmanageable. The relationships that I have will no longer be there. And I might end up in prison again. She dropped to her knees and she was crying against the door, right? Because she had no other option. And honestly, that's the thing that saved my life. That moment where she said, enough is enough, Nathan. You need to make some changes. And until you make some changes, we are not here for you. Today I'm free, man. That physical freedom, that mental freedom, that spiritual freedom that we have in this recovery, this journey of recovery, is really a beautiful thing. So I just wanna say, if you know somebody or you yourself, are feeling hopeless, man, just know that there is somebody out there, man, and there's many people out there who have lived that lifestyle, have lived through it and have made some changes in their life, right? And they're not living that lifestyle anymore, man. It's possible. You know, recovery is possible. The word recovery, the definition of that word has really evolved for me over the past 7 years. You know, I remember first coming into recovery, I thought that that word meant that I didn't use drugs or alcohol, that I didn't ingest them. And that's what it meant for me in the beginning. And that was very valuable for me in the beginning because I was able to clear my head. I was able to clear my emotions and to clear my body, right? And get stable-minded to the point where that word and that experience of recovery has really evolved for me. You know, it went from just being abstinent to, you know, recovery is that you're going to 12-step meetings and that you have a sponsor and that you're sponsoring people. And that's what recovery meant to me. And today, you know, really what the word recovery means to me is that if you are a person, you know, that's working every day to improve your quality of life, you are an individual in recovery, right? And that's really where I am today in my recovery, right? Is that today recovery for me is not allowing people to walk all over me. You know, today recovery for me is, you know, having self-worth and self-value. You know, today recovery for me is telling the truth and having integrity and being honest, right? And showing up for work and showing up for my team, showing up for my family members, paying my taxes, paying my bills, you know, the registration of my car and my insurance, right? This is really what recovery has evolved into.